0-2. Got him with the fastball, and the Aztecs win it 4-3.
With the fourth selection of the 2015 MLB Draft, the Texas Rangers select Dylan Tate, a right-handed pitcher from UC Santa Barbara.
Season opener for a UCSB baseball team that hosted their first ever NCAA regional last year. Shane Bieber has been elevated to Gaucho Ace this year. Strong first outing against the San Francisco Dons. He goes seven innings, gave up just two runs, struck out four. But the story of this one was returning second baseman J.J. Munoz. First pitch he sees this year, he ropes a double to right center. He would score the first run of the season on an infield single by Kyle Plantier. And the Gauchos win their opener.
I'm going to go with the Gauchos out here on the West Coast, surprise champion, really, of the 20-win Classic, and they just pummeled everybody. There's three straight blowout wins. Just didn't see it coming, Kendall. A team that lost seven starters from last year, completely rebuilt lineup. You got one real established guy who's dangerous with Andrew Kalika at the top of the lineup, and then a bunch of newer faces starting, you know, and Kyle Plantier and Austin Bush in the middle are good players. They can really hit. Up and down the lineup, they were just so competitive with their at-bats, really well coached. And, you know, they're a little thin on the mound, but they gotten the most out of those guys. And their starters were able to go deep enough to kind of keep the bullpen from getting too taxed. So they're very interesting. You know, I didn't think they'd be a postseason team heading into the season. They might wind up being one.
No balls, two strikes. Davis looks at second. Curve, swung on and missed. Southall goes, and the pitch is hit slowly up the third baseline. It's a fair ball. Clark behind the bag throws him out at first base. And the 1-2 to Adams. Swung on and line down the left field line. That's going to get into the corner. The Gauchos are on the board. Grover comes in to score. Here comes Muno to score. And we are tied at two on an opposite field double by Josh Adams. 3-2. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss. And a breaking pitch, delayed steal. Throw to second. And the tag is made by Fisher. What a play by Clay. 3-2. Swung on and driven to right center field. Robinson, the center fielder, moving over. The right fielder, Oppenheim, moving over. They can't get it. It gets between them. Rounding third. Coming in to score is Grover on a triple by Muno. And it's 5-2 Gauchos.
How about Andrew Checkett's team? They haven't skipped a beat. I mean, if anything, their record's probably better than it was this time last season. Shane Bieber has certainly been solid, but Kyle Nelson out of the bullpen has been absolute rock, has been just pinpoint command, 30 strikeouts, 3 walks, and 25 and a third. And Noah Davis has been a nice infusion for those guys.
The Gauchos had lost 3 of 4 heading into this three-game home set with Big West leading Cal State Fullerton. Bottom of the second, UCSB strikes first. J.J. Muno rips a solo home run to right. It's his fifth big fly this year. That's the second most of the team. It gets hairy for Fullerton in the fifth. Connor Siebold serves it up, and freshman Sam Cohen sends it out. It's Sam's first collegiate home run. Gauchos up 2-1, and UCSB goes on to win the opener 3-2 to move to within 2 games of Fullerton for first place.
Three, two pitch. Runner goes, and it's hit in the air, shallow center. Kalika charging in. He dives, and he comes up with a catch.
Has been a competition amongst three catchers. There's a base at the left field.
It's a long run for Grant Palmer. Coming around first base, hustling for second is Muno, and he'll hit first slide in with a double.
They'll take advantage of any weakness that you have.
1-1 bunted towards the mound. Runner's coming home. Throw there. He's not in time. 1-2, curve ball, grounded softly to short. Fisher up with it, has to hurry, and he beats Kruder by a step. 1-2, swung on and missed, strike three.
Best team in the West in the RPI is still somehow Santa Barbara. They've actually stabilized. They were dropping. I think they were down toward 30. Now they're back up to 20.
UCSB baseball team will try to be a big hit in Nashville this weekend.
Let's go to Nashville. We got Vanderbilt, UC Santa Barbara, Washington Xavier. This is another pretty easy one for me. I'm going Vanderbilt. I think Santa Barbara's a soft two. I think Washington's a perfectly capable three that could make a little noise. But Vanderbilt's pitching is just so far above everybody else here. To the right-hand side of the bracket, Louisville and UC Santa Barbara. This one is good luck to Santa Barbara because Louisville is just a machine. And you know, like you got to credit Santa Barbara for having, I think, a great, great year. I mean, they have some balance in the lineup, but they don't have a lot of other guys that scare you at Santa Barbara. You know, it's just they're scrappy. They're well-coached. They got some tough outs. But, I mean, you look at Louisville's lineup, it's just insane to me how good they are. Shoots up through the stony.
Center, the pitch swung on and popped up. This should be in play. Foul territory, first base side. Bush makes the catch. The Gauchos have defeated Louisville.
And the reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck. And you're not moving anywhere. You thought you found a friend to take you out of this place.
Swung on and driven high and deep to right field. Out of here. Gauchos are going to Omaha. Can you believe it?
Mike Rooney, you and I have witnessed a lot of super regionals in our time. I have never seen a more improbable ending than what we just saw.
Come on, Omaha, baby! Come on, let's go! Let's go!
Absolutely was a childhood dream. That moment, I've been thinking about that. It's something you dream of as a kid. You know, down by three, bases loaded, bottom of the ninth, walk-off grand slam.
I can't believe that came true.
I see the ball come off his bat, and I knew it was out.
I knew right when I stepped on first base that it went out. Then I don't remember anything.
I was just jumping up and down, screaming around the bases.
I thought I was in a dream, actually. It was just surreal, and it was crazy to be living in that moment like that.
I think I strained a muscle celebrating. I lost my breath for a few seconds.
As soon as it went up, everyone kind of knew it was out of there, and the first thing that went through my mind is, wow, we're going to Omaha.
It's just awesome being one of the final eight teams, and we're looking to extend it.
this is something that you dream of as a kid, and it's just amazing to be living it right now.
It's obviously an amazing accomplishment for us and our team, but we're all competitors out there, and we want to win this thing. You know, we're here, might as well win it.
I sure hope we're going to continue this magical run. That would be fantastic. At this point, I can't rule anything out with this group.
We're the underdog. We've been the underdog from the beginning of the postseason, so I think this club loves it. I think we embrace it, and I think we're ready to prove some people wrong.
5-0 in the postseason, we've been riding that first game win, you know, all the way, and we're going to bring it in Omaha.
How many home runs had you had prior to that? This is your freshman year, right?
Yes.
Okay, so how many home runs had you had this year?
This year I had one before that.
So you're not the guy most likely to hit a walk-off grand slam to send his team to the College World Series.
I guess not.
And are you third string catcher?
Yes, sir.
You're not still third string catcher. You got to be elevated to second string at least now, Sam. Right?
I mean, hey, it's I try to do my part any way I can.
This 6 months ago that I'd be sitting here with this group. Sometimes I feel like I'm coaching 12-year-olds because they're so loose and so squirrely, and I'm wound a lot tighter than they are, and they really thrive by just going out and playing and having fun. So the message to these guys about you know, the fans and the atmosphere and all that stuff is just enjoy it, soak it in, embrace the moment, have fun with it, and make sure that you're playing hard and going for it.
Drills this one out towards left center field. Littell and Sluder, neither of them are going to get it. Littell picks it up. Muno into second and a man into scoring position.
Tough when you're facing teams like the Gauchos. They bunt, they run, so the delays.
Runner goes, pitch out, throw down, tag. Oh, nice play. Match draft. I have him as our number one pick as he rips that one into right center field. He goes 6'6", 265.
Second and third, and a ground ball up the middle will do the job for them.
Oh, my goodness. Caught out of the air. Fisher steps on second, and they get a double play.
In the Hall of Fame of the Rangers this year.
Got him.
Hey, Omaha, you're gonna see this. The hotel is gonna
check swing. Did he go? You bet.
Sometimes you just don't know what to do out there.
Towards third, diving stab Clark. Nice play. The 2-2. Got him swinging. Ball game.
I speak for all the guys. This was one of the best experiences of my life, and we're not ready for that to end.
We are not done yet. We find a way today. Let's go.
Yeah. Get ball.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Breaking ball, and that'll get through. Around and in to score is Fisher, and it's a 1-1 game. Got him looking. A swing and a miss. Nice breaking ball. Bunted towards third. Clark picks it up. Nice play. And our first rain delay here in the 2016 College World Series. Hit hard, fair ball, and that one heading towards the right field corner. Bradford heading towards third, and they're going to hold him up. Muno into second. And just like that, UCSB 2 in scoring position. Fair ball. Bradford in to score. Muno on his heels. Abreu will collect it, stopping over there at third after the Cumberland knock is Grover, and UCSB leads 3-1. Bunted towards first, and the safety squeeze works. And the throw gets past Johnny Ruiz. Down to third goes Cumberland. They add another, and it is 4-1.
Do it again.
There they do it again. And it works again. Good call. 5-1. Oh, 2 now. Picked up. Muno to Fisher. Double play. Nice pitch by Nelson. Payoff pitch. Got him. Back to the mound. They get one there. They turn it, and UCSB has eliminated Miami. 5-3 the final, and the Gauchos are staying put right here in Omaha. First College World Series win in the history of the program for J.J. Muno's UCSB Gauchos.
Happy for our guys, our fans, and everybody celebrating like we just won the whole thing. But it's hard to act like you've done it before when you've never done it before. So first program World Series win, and it sure looked like it.
We all knew that we'd been working hard, and we were all ready for our opportunities. We got guys that have grinded out years where they've just sat the bench, and we kind of have a tough junior class that was ready for their opportunity and ready to prove people wrong. It's an awesome feeling to have that camaraderie pay off and come out with a victory.
Boyd bounces it to short, collected by Fisher, throw to first in time. Line drive over the leaping Boyd into left field.
It's rocket science.
There he goes. The swing and a miss.
I mean, outstanding from the mound.
Did he go? Yes, he did. A swing and a miss, another strikeout.
Oof.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. There you go.
See you later.
Sometimes it's very hard to get a rally going, just taking pitches.
That one ripped out into left center field. Fisher has a double. Ming ready. Got him swinging. Arizona wins it. And the dream is over for UCSB. Wave out to the crowd and take our final bow.
Oh, it's our time to go, but at least we stole the show. All I could do is thank them. Thank them for their effort. Thank them for their hard work. Thank them for their commitment. Thank them for representing our university the right way. Once you get here, you can understand why people kind of get it in their blood and want to come back, because the experience is so special. So, you know, for us to be able to get here and have some guys that will return and really understand, and even a coach that really understands what Omaha means, going to be a little bit different and have a little different meaning for myself and the guys that are on our team next year.